Ajak by three. For real. Nah, they're playing Demon Souls. Don't tell me this nigga's online and on the phone and not in the party. Is he on? Oh. Roasty. Yeah, tell him I say HI. From afar, I still could hit you. Reverie so precise again. Yeah. He should know about you yet. Yeah. I just got the 40. Reverie while inside of him. They say if I live by him, one day I'ma die by him. I'm riding on my own. Cracking for my time, ain't much for my time froze. She know how to play a role. You know that song, you rhyme, let me know. Grind me up the post. Gotta show me what it is. I keep got iron on me for sure. It took some time, I realized. Open my eyes. I'm super blind, open fine. I'm closing his eyes. So life's a gamble, roll the job. Like rolling the dice. Now you caught up in the storm, I bring what's on the most. Like that pain, I hurt the most. Told her I got dope dick, and now she wanna dope. She know I'm an animal, she wanna fuck the goat guy. You don't know what I've been through. Say it's gonna be about it, get your issue. Touch the scope, so from afar I still can hit you. Put the money on his top, same price as Christian loot. I got a dev game, man. Take it easy on me. I wish I got a dev game on somebody else, like a running back. I got fucking dev game on Duvernay. Whack 'em. Easy will be taking on you. So from afar, I still can hit you. 26 and also a first down. First down, Eagles. Niggas is yelling. That guy was yelling. Yeah, God.
It's Brady. That's complete. It's Devin Duvernay. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone.
Boy, a pair of big plays here.
This one going for 29. Pretty good start right off the bat. He's not locking in on just one target early, is he? Spreading it around a little bit.
Now, I got a dev game with Duvernay, though. I doubt he's going to get four touchdowns, though.
Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. And 10 right at the 20.
But they Paul. Out the road.
Here's
Brady to throw. Sheesh. I only threw that because I saw you were on a lineman.
And he'll get it down this time to the 17. 3 yards the game there, second down.
I'm here tonight, there. I'm Caspar.
The fuck?
No matter what, you really can't. And my nigga is looking right there. They catch you at some last spot, nigga.
Where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going
to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that.
Ever since that, I feel like the brown boy, back.
Shut the fuck up, Nev. You're whack.
I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Look at that D-line.
We never went down into mistakes. We didn't get back to it. These days.
Play action. Now it's Brady. They'll roll him out right.
In themselves. And I'm here now.
So much for the best laid plans and best design plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines.
Ball back.
No place for that one to get in.
Huh?
It sails in
completely. All good. All good.
Bunch of.
Throwing that XD, nigga. That breeze, nigga. We getting money. Please don't act like you know me. I'm not your brother, don't you run me, no cap.
Season. And the Eagles drive right down the field and score the opening drive. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Cairo Santos. Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. And this will make it into the end zone. And he returns this.
Crunch this, nigga. I was gonna grab you and it was to rip you in half.
The first carry for the shifty Tariq Cohen. And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there to bring up a second and nine.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he'll be out right at the 35. 11 yards there, first down. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number 4 in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't
alligator shoe on a pedal when I press it.
From, working his way into the secondary, figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself a big. You give yourself
a paddocks on paddocks, dude.
And drag him 4 yards.
Bad thing, so, because then you turn into a shootout.
Better off mine, you.
Has to keep pace.
It's a gain of 4. Makes it 3rd and 2.
On 3rd and 2, McDonald.
I knew it was going there, bro. I knew it was going there, and I didn't do anything to stop it.
He doubled that. He got 6. It goes as a gain of 6, and it's a first down.
Put that on my game. Put that right on my mother.
This is Cohen. Able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. A Chicago first down there on a gain of 11. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game and leaned on other people to give them the yardage that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
Here's a first down throw that's complete. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first?
When they needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
First down, a run with Cohen. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8.
That boy, Devin.
Three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7. Now a shotgun handoff to Cohen. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3.
Well, at that rate, picking up 3 yards of carry, you and I both know that doesn't cut it in this league in trying to get first downs, unless you're playing 4-down football. Then that's a whole different situation. But I don't think that's what they're trying to do here. 3rd and 4, though, is still manageable.
Opening carry of the game for Cordero Patterson. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for. One of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there.
You not care. Make her fear. But I don't care.
And they're gonna at least line up to go for on 4th down.
Good defense, Bilal.
Incomplete. They can't hook up here on the 4th down pass attempt. And the Eagles defense able to hold. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number 1 seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today.
Right.
So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number 1 in their conference.
Behind the chain, 2nd and 12. Here's the option. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Almost unstoppable.
I did the triple option instead of the power option by accident. I almost fucked up. I never do triple option. Just because that handoff's too slow.
Yeah, it's not going to be in the greatest hits, is it? Because they didn't hit anyone on that play. Supposed to have them pinned back deep. Instead, they leave a big crack, a gaping hole, and guess what? They're in bad position right now.
26 big yards on that one. It's another first down. Boy, an effective play there, getting their wideouts involved in the run game.
I mean, they're always hoping on that type of a play, if they can get to the end of the line and have a chance to turn it upfield as he did there, that means they controlled the blocking and took care of the defensive end or the outside linebacker to give him that lane.
And I guess I need to clarify, I said getting their wideouts involved in the run game, but of course that was actually a pass as he popped it forward. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. Into the red zone, it's Brady.
CD, let's go. Oh, he wow, what just happened? He caught it? That's a ball on the floor.
Able to push further out in front.
Now that touchdown won't allow you to totally relax, but you can breathe a little easier now.
Bro, I love that nigga CD Lamb, bro.
Santos with the extra point, and it's now 14 to nothing. Now, after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they used the
term? Scrugged them off.
Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. And his pass incomplete. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all. And I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29. They go play action with McDonald. Over the middle to Beckham. Accelerating and off he goes. Touchdown, Chicago. Odell Beckham, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Bears have cut it to within a score. They were already down two scores early. They needed something
Dong.
To try to stay wow. tied, and that certainly qualifies a big play to get him in the end zone.
It qualifies indeed.
But that shit was gonna boing.
They don't get something done on this drive. Turn it back over. This game could be 88 and out the gate early.
What? 88 and out the gate?
Yeah.
What's that?
Well, listen, I used to hear my old man talk about it. Usually meant that thing's done.
Well, now that they got the touchdown, it's not 88 and out the gate. We still got a good game going ahead of us.
At their own 19-yard line.
Offense set to begin their next drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Second and seven.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Back to the ground, this time with Jones. Ronald calling a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about five.
It's a gain of 2 yards, and it's third down.
Now Brady.
Why did he take so long to throw? Bro, I threw it right after I snapped.
Fourth down now after a
oh, my God.
That's a nice clip and save sequence there.
That's bullshit.
They did everything as they would have wanted to.
And then my power doesn't register. Like, are you shitting me?
Nowhere to go with the football. Force the dump off to the back, and even then they close quickly and get him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Shrugs a hit stick. My control freak goes flying off the remote.
12 yards on the return that time, and it'll be a short field for the Bears as they take over first and 10. First and 10, McDonald.
Yo, light him up.
And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. A good pick up there, 26 yards. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
Looking to throw on second down. McDonald, and it's caught. And the Bears are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves him all the way down to the one. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. They'll run for it with Tariq Cohen, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Tariq Cohen hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Bears are an extra.
Unbelievable, bro. I would have fucking converted that third down. This nigga would have threw it right away.
Good with a PAT. And we've got a tie game here, a back and forth first half. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back in my feet and get right. Watch me work, watch me take. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And that 14-0 lead to begin the ball game, well, that's gone now. Time to regroup.
I think even up two touchdowns, they knew this wasn't going to be a walk in the park, and I think that's
wide open hole. He can't even fucking hit it.
Sidelines telling his team, let's stay with it, let's keep going. It's almost like he knew they were going to make their run at him, and they have. As you said, let's see if they can regroup and get going again.
Once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Now Brady. Escaping the pressure right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. Something we haven't really seen much of from him. An incomplete pass.
Yeah, last week he finished at 70%. This week he's up over 80%. I don't know how you slow him down. Pass rush is usually the best way, because a quarterback on his back usually can't complete a pass.
He was ripping through his coat.
Second down. Ebron caught left side. And he
Ebron, unhook the trailer, you big bastard.
Right down around the goal line. Big play there for the Eagles. 63 yards. After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal. Shotgun now for Brady. Flush to his right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. They don't get the hookup there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's a perfect word for it, precise. Because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
Now Brady again, eluding the pressure right. And he takes a shot on the release, as this will be incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
This Bears defense trying to hold on. This is third and goal. To pick it up, and he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. It's their quarterback, his first touchdown on the year, and the Eagles have taken the lead. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and the lead is now 21-14.
Cairo Santos set
now after the touchdown here. Santos to kick this one away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes back-to-back. What a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a 2-for-1 without ever even giving up the football. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. From the gun, it's McDonald. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing again, McDonald. And he completes it to Cohen. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
First and 10 at the 43-yard line.
From the gun, McDonald. He'll drop this one down to Cohen. And he's going to have a first down, and they get into field goal range here at the 29. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two.
I get stuck on fucking Boza. Jesus Christ. That's a cover four. What's going on? That shit does not make sense. He's wide open over the top on a cover four. It just doesn't make sense.
Teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the scores, the kicks away.
Fucking bullshit ass game, bro.
And taken successfully.
Get stuck on fucking Boza. Get the fuck out of here. At their own 25-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And we're under a minute to go here. What's been an even first half all tied up?
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. A couple completions just
wrong fucking way. Why do you go that way?
Let's see what happens.
Brady now on first down. Left side, it's complete. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already.
Oh, why is Stradler in? That's terrible.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw.
Oh my God, bro. Why is he in? Why is he not running, bro? He's the only person that could have caught him and he wasn't running. I couldn't even switch to him. Bro.
That's bullshit. Fucking bullshit. This nigga CeeDee Lamb's wide open. Fucking Stradler can't even get the ball out. Get the fuck out of here. Yes.
Second half, it was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
They're on 24-yard line.
Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Yeah, points certainly not at a premium here. On first down, Cohen. And some room to maneuver.
You want to talk about bullshit? You really want to talk about bullshit? Tariq Cohen is not shrugging off. Tariq Cohen is not shrugging off anybody in the fucking world. He's not shrugging off anybody in the world, let alone Devin fucking Bush. He's not even a rookie. He's like a fucking 93 overall. He was over top of both of them. I leave him. I did. It's a good blocks. Good blocks are more realistic than Tariq Cohen shrugging this nigga Bush. He didn't weave Fred Warner. Fred Warner was chasing him now. That was a zig, not a corner route. The corner route was there, but I didn't throw it to him.
So far with their first possessions here in the third quarter, so we're right back to where we started at intermission.
Yeah, how about that? Tied at the half, tied after the first two drives of the third quarter, one for each. That tells me that someone's defense has got to step up and make a big play and try and change the momentum of this game.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Now they'll run it with Cohen. And he'll be upended at the 33. Guess what? It brings up third down.
The 33-yard line. That's a gain of three.
Here's McDonald off of the play fake. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
That's good. The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. first down. McDonald, the screen pass here to Cohen. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Mark that down as a pickup of 13, and the Bears have the first.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
On first and 10, McDonald. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
So much about defending the pass is being able to be right there the moment the ball gets to the receiver, and he was right in his hip pocket, helping force that incompletion.
Third quarter, all tied up. This is second and 10. To throw again, McDonald. This is the tight end, Njoku. That'll leave them with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Second down pass play got them 8 yards. Now they've got a third and a couple remaining. A shotgun handoff to Patterson. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Give him 2 yards on that play. And it's going to yield a new set of downs. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. 35 is the mic. Operating from the gun. McDonald. That is caught by Cohen. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 18 yards on that one, and Chicago has the first. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Second and 7 at the 14-yard line.
Now Cohen. And it takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of 3.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive will take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
A field goal would get them the lead, but that's not what they're shooting for as they come up on third down. From the gun, McDonald. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. So two third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with fourth down. So here's Greg Zuerlein now as he'll try for the field goal.
A 29-yard attempt.
And Zuerlein's kick is good. And it's 3-0. The Bears hit the scoreboard first. So a dozen plays on that drive, CD, but in the end, it yields just the 3 points.
Well, they were able to keep the defense on the field for a long time, but let's be honest about it. That was about as unsatisfying a drive as you're going to get. 12 plays and you only get 3 points out of it. Not quite the ending they were looking for.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
The job of any linebacker involves having enough strength to fight off a blocker and get to ball carriers. But in this case, I think we can safely say he beat him right off the snap to get into the backfield and make that play. 50, 50.
second and 12. Brady. Caught on the right side by Jones. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain.
I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
To throw, it's Brady. That's taken in by Duvernay. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Seven catches for him now in this last one, a first down. And Brady's throw there, incomplete. Devin Duvernay, the intended receiver, but it'll be second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Brady gonna fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. Every penalty so critical at this stage of the game as now they've got it third and long. Brady to throw again. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. If they didn't have that penalty a moment ago, it'd be a first down. Still a nice 13-yard pickup. The Eagles send out their punter now as he'll punt it away for the second time. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And the Bears take over. Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37.
I got the sense that the defense created a little momentum for them there, didn't it?
Did their job, forced the punt. Now, nice start to the drive. Offense has to do their part.
Yeah, they certainly do, but what a great start for them. They've got to go thank the guys on D.
Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave them with a third and about three to go.
No gain on the play. It's third down and four.
From the gun, McDonald, and the throw there gonna be incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's Johnny Hacker now, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. He punted five times in the win last week as this one's away. This returnable for Ayuk. 54 yards on the punt, 12 on the return. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10.
Their own 18-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. Pass taken in by the tight end Herndon. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10. At the 18.
On the counter, here's Jones. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
Sometimes it's a danger putting that jumbo set out there. You just get a lot of bodies massed in one location. You can wind up with 18, 20, maybe even all 22 in the box, and there's nowhere to run the football.
Throwing is Brady on third down. Ebron with it over the middle. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. He has a first down, and that catch will also put him over 100 yards receiving now on the afternoon. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And seeing no option. interceptions. He just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but if they make them out of bounds, that does you no good.
Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. That's complete to his receiver, Ayuk. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. But plays like that, Charles, no doubt, they're just going to continue to fuel this crowd.
And this defense is already playing well, but it also feeds on the energy of that crowd that you're talking about, and that takes them up to another level. Right now, they're playing really loose. They've got the lead, and what a nice stop they just made there behind the line of scrimmage.
So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. To throw on third down, Brady. Open man, Lamb. It's complete. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Complete. CeeDee Lamb with his 13th touchdown of the year and second of the game. And once again, the Eagles are back out in front.
The extra
and he knocks it through.
Makes the score Eagles 42, Bears 38.
Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
First and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Rolling to his left, and that is incomplete. Johnson was the intended receiver, and it's second down. Got out of the pocket, didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice, get rid of it, live to fight another down.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. He'll look to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. It's Devin Bush, the linebacker, who picks it.
Yo, good fucking game, bro. For real. Oh, I just farted. Nah, for real, bro. Oh my god, I needed that. For real. That was literally it, bro. Whoever's offense got stopped first.
Yo, don't do me like that. I did watch some of that game though. Nah, I didn't peep. He was probably sick. Someone go get his ass. This nigga's name is Cole.
This one is incomplete.
Slaw.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it. Unable to successfully find the end zone over the top. They go play action with McDonald. Now a desperate.
Oh my.
Oh!
We didn't get that far.
Bro, he really, like, I want to like his music just because it sounds like pop. Like, there's no reason to hate on it, but he sounds exactly like him. He's using his ad-libs, everything. Hey, that shit's corny as hell. Holy shit. He was behind him, man. A debiter? Debiter. I did not get this dev game. Nah, he needs 4 touchdowns or 200 yards. No clue. About to see. This thing is out of stamina. I'm not going to score. Hold on. Let me see his yards. Two yards away. Hold on. Oh, he's tired? Where the fuck is he at? I was about to. Appreciate you.
There's a major. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Freak of nature.
Oh!
Quick throw by Brady complete. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. A good pick up there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Coach suggestion said kneel. It had no kneel in it. The fuck?
No Keanu.
No, Keanu. Nah, for real. That was crazy. Fuck.